He said there ain't no rest for the wicked. Money don't grow on trees. I got bills to pay, I got mouths to feed. There ain't nothing in this world for free. I know I can't slow down, I can't hold back. Though you know I wish I could. Oh no, there ain't no rest for the wicked until we close our eyes for good. Everybody back again, and today we're working on the crossbow a little bit more. As you can see, I took my knob off of here that was screwed in. We're going to heat this piece of PVC up and form fit it into there to create a little bit of a slip point where the string can go off and slide off a little smoother because the wood is pretty grabby. For one, this will help the string last longer. For two, it'll make it release smoother. I'm going to be using another foot of PVC to make our trigger mechanism. This is gonna sit up here like suchly, and you'll see how it goes together once I get it made. But it's going to be attached to either side of the bow and have two prongs that come up to release the string. So we're gonna start with our little piece that's gonna become our slip joint. I'm just gonna go ahead and heat this up. This one shouldn't take very long at all because it's such a teeny tiny little piece. And we're gonna be epoxying this in place later. This is also gonna add a considerable amount of strength and wear resistance to where the string notches up. So now we've got our little piece form fitted. You'll notice it has a nice radius to it, so that way when the string latches on there, the string is only bent around it. For our trigger mechanism, this is going to be kind of tricky. The way I'm going to end up doing this is going to be quite a bit of heat molding. First, we're gonna flatten it out entirely. Then I'm gonna run a rip cut up the middle of it. Once I have those limbs made, I'll be able to heat shape them into the prongs that I'm going for releasing the string. And I'll be able to shape this end into the handle. Hot noodle, hot noodle, hot noodle. Okay, and we're just gonna go ahead and step on this on both sides. Just kind of wiggle back and forth until it starts to flatten down. And you'll feel it. You'll feel it starting to flatten out. Then make sure it's straight, just like that. Now comes the tricky part. I'm gonna start bending this to fit my crossbow here. So I just wanted to show you guys where we are sitting now. I still need to change the angle on my lever here just to make it look cool so it's not just sticking way the heck out the bottom of the device. I'm gonna kind of curve this back gently against the stock itself. I've split my PVC like I was telling you guys, and then I've created an area under here where it can rotate down on itself. And what's gonna happen is when that string's sitting in there, all you gotta do is put a little pressure here and these risers will pop that string right off. And what's really cool about the angle on this that I've done is when you fire that, as soon as that string comes off, it can slide in between those two ramps right there. There's just enough room in between those two ramps to let that string fly and grab the bolt very cleanly. You'll notice it's countersunk all the way through. Basically, what I did is I heated it up, flattened these limbs just enough to fit around the bow, then drilled them in when they were hot. From there, I just sculpted it by hand until both sides had that identical kind of elephant nose looking angle. We've got our trigger mechanism shaped, and that is a nice, elegant, wavy kind of trigger mechanism. Nice little handle. You'll notice these knots on the string here. These are not actually tight. They're able to roll. So when the elephant nose goes up and the trunk rolls against the bottom of it, it's actually going to make that string roll forward. Now, this will be important later. Just keep this in mind for now. There's a little bit of take up in the trigger before you fire. So you can have your hand right underneath there and then just open your hand and it'll fire. So this should be a pretty cool little device. We're gonna take our two screws out and we're gonna paint this. Now got our trigger mechanism painted. did repaint the crossbow. It's drying right now. I'll show you guys that here in a second. So here is our painted and assembled crossbow. I am going to do a paracord wrap over the handle just for looks and for comfort. I mean, that's kind of your cheek rest and your shooting handle, and it vibrates a little bit when you shoot it. So I'm gonna wrap that in paracord just so that way it doesn't vibrate against your cheek, makes it a little more comfortable to shoot and looks, you know, a little bit more professional. So here's our finished trigger built in retainer, lug made, all that jazz. I actually replaced the lug we had in here. You see it tore out right there. It actually blew out because I upped the power just a tiny bit, maybe to 80 pounds on this, and it yeah, blew that plastic shelf right off. So I changed it out with kind of like a spring-loaded aluminum one. That's gonna allow the string to knock back on there, but also as the string flips up, it'll push it out of the way so it has a straight shot to take the arrow off the shelf. Let me get this loaded up so I can show you what it looks like with a bolt in there. So with a bolt in there, you can see that, well, let's see if we can get you an angle. You can kind of see that steel pin is stopping our bolt from contacting the string. So as I press on that trigger to release the string, it'll drop that, it'll roll forward, drop that pin out of the way, and pull the bolt out, allowing it to fly perfectly straight. Get a couple test shots done. That way you guys can see how it functions with the trigger and how the trigger works. You want to see how it does?
Yeah.
I want you to shoot it.
No, puppy.
Please.
Okay.
Thumb here, front hand. It's ambidextrous, so it works either way. Okay. This is your front grip.
Okay.
Put your cheek against here. You can look straight down the top of the bolt. You slowly pull forward on it until it fires.
Oh,
let it surprise you.
Whoa!
What do you think?
That's powerful.
You like it?
Yeah.
So we're out here at about 20 yards. This was the same distance we were shooting from on the maximum end of that range last time. Since I bumped it up to 80 pounds now instead of 60-ish pounds, it's thumping a bit harder. But I want to see what the difference between the 60 and the 80 is like on the crossbow at 20 yards on the hardwood. If you remember, they were only going this far into the particle board and that far into the hardwood at 20 yards. So let's see what we can do with the higher poundage. Hit a little high on this one. That one sunk all the way in, and that one sunk about the same distance as before into the hardwood. Let's try that again. It's sinking a lot deeper into the foam, but it's acting about the same as it did before on the particle board. So not much of a difference on the hard target, but on the soft target, it's getting another quarter inch into the target from 20 yards. The main thing I've noticed, and you probably noticed too, is this is shooting a much tighter grouping consistently. And that's probably to do with the trigger mechanism. And I'm gonna show you guys what it's like for this to be firing towards, so you can see the flight of the projectile, hopefully. This is our grouping. They're sticking in really good. I actually got a bullseye with it. That's really freaking cool. So yeah, the trigger definitely, definitely aids in accuracy on this. So having our trigger mechanism is definitely aiding in accuracy, as well as the way I've designed this. You'll notice this knuckle kind of tapers back a little bit and it's flat on the top. What that lets me do is roll the string over top of it, so it's kind of rolled back into place. This trigger will ride it, and as you can see, it'll start to roll that string forward. That one I fired at point blank range just to show you guys. It buried very, very deeply into that target. This is what it does at 20 yards. At point blank range, it goes in that far. That roll pin mechanism works flawlessly. I had my doubts about it when I blew that shelf off originally, but works great. So you got this just to set up on your shoulder so you can look straight down the bolt at whatever you're gonna wanna hit. And I can see straight line right down that bolt to aim. And then all I have to do is come up here and hold that and just kind of pull it down ever so slightly until it lets go. just like that. Unlike the last video, I'm not gonna have to sit here and try and pry that off with my finger. I've got all this leverage here, so I can use my entire hand if I want to just pop that loose. Last video I said these were 13 inch, I was wrong, these are 16 inch bolts, and that shelf is exactly 16 inches. So the point just barely sticks out in front of that. I am gonna be doing further videos with this. It's gonna require blacksmithing. We're gonna be making steel arrowheads and lighter bolts and longer bolts and shorter bolts and play around with bolts. I think that'll be a fun thing. This will be a fun little experiment deal for the channel. What kind of damage different bolts do out of an 80 pound crossbow that's homemade. And the best part about this is if you're a blacksmith or you have the capability to get into blacksmithing, you'll be able to replicate everything I'm doing for yourself. So you'll be able to see my trials and errors, what works, what fails, all that kind of stuff as we move forward doing this. It will be a continuing series on the channel because we're gonna make some wild arrowheads. For now, we're stuck with our half inch hardwood, heavy, heavy bolts, 11 ounce bolts with the fletching and everything. So they are heavy bolts. These are definitely closer range bolts because they're so heavy, but within a closer range, they're devastating, as you guys saw. Now we're gonna go back to 20 yards and have some fun now that this is complete. I've got a couple of targets here. We've got quarter inch thick cowhide leather in front of a piece of styrofoam. Then we're gonna try and hit some of these Pepsi cans as well. That one we hit right here, kind of coming in on an angle, but you can see the impact on that at 20 yards. It punched through that aluminum with those copper tips and it bent the crap out of it. So I'm assuming it hit and swung like that. So let's try and get a cleaner shot. I've got them up against the back now, so there's a little more weight there. Looks like I'm still hitting a little high. Yeah, I just hit near it. Dang it. Looks like on that last one it hit the rim and deflected. It's pretty wild. You know, for 20 yards with a little crossbow with no sights, this thing's pretty accurate. Hey, hey, hey! We got one. Now we can actually see what it did to the target. So it went through, blew a huge hole in the front, and it actually stuck that far through into the wood. So that's quite a bit of thump for 20 yards out of a little crossbow. Now let's see how it does against our little rabbit. You can see where we hit. It almost made it through that first side. And then this one hit and stuck through all the way. It just didn't have quite enough force to stay in the foam. You can actually see a little bit of foam that blew out right there. Definitely strong enough for squirrels and birds. At least with these heavy, heavy bolts. With a faster bolt, I'm sure I'd be able to get much better penetration. So all in all, I would say the crossbow build was a success. Our trigger mechanism functions beautifully. The cheek rest that I made with that paracord's nice and comfortable, so you can shoot this thing all day. This isn't gonna hurt your fingers to shoot because of the trigger. It's gonna fire pretty accurately, even at 25 yards. Spring latch down here, that is actually a big improvement compared to what that shelf that I was planning before, because I feel like this is more efficient. I had epoxied that shelf in there and it blew off with the chunk of the wood. And I'm gonna leave that there to remind myself of that when I show you this, because it's not gonna weaken the tool, just a little blemish that comes along with the experiment, I guess. But if you guys like what you've seen, you know what to do. Do the thing right there. Until next time, God bless, stay sharp out there. If you're looking for a custom sharp object, check out the Etsy store.